Shout out to my boy Heartbeat.
So this is 5-9 in your book on parallel and perpendicular lines. And Harpneet, this one is for you. And I had to put in my own dates on the calendar today. We miss you.
Hi, Harpneet.
Okay.
Love you.
When you rewrite these.
Hi, future me.
Can we get back on tab? When you rewrite these in a list like this, you notice that the slopes are then lined up. And you can say these two are going to be parallel. This one would be zero slope. It has no MX, right? So it's tricky because it has a 6 there, but is it a 6X?
No.
So it's not going to be parallel with these. Mm-hmm. Let's write number 3 down. It has 4 equations. Serenity, I'd like to see you writing these with us too. The first one is y is equal to 3/4 x minus 1. I'm going to put over here y equals negative 2x because I'm noticing already these two are not going to line up with each other. Negative or 3/4 x is never going to be parallel to negative 2x because this negative 2, 3/4 totally different slopes. What? The next equation is, I see a 3/4 in it, so I'm going to put it on this side. It says y minus 3 equals 3/4 times x minus 5. That's in point slope form. The first thing we'd have to do is to distribute this 3/4 to this x, and what would that become? 3/4 x. And then we'd end up with 3/4 times negative 5. You don't even have to go further. This right here is going to become parallel.
I don't get it.
Me neither.
Well, then let me continue it. Y minus 3 equals 3/4 x minus 15 over 4. What's the slope in that equation right now? What was the slope in the first equation? That's why they're parallel. Do you see it now? I can simplify this by adding 3 to both sides. Y is going to be equal to 3/4 x. And then, okay, well, let's simplify this. 15 over 4 would be...
No, I'm just kidding.
I wish it was 16 over 4. That would make life easier, but it's not. There's 3 and 2/4, 3.5.
So 6.5.
Right? So it would be 6.5.
I don't know if I should watch this for now.
Again, this first equation is parallel with this equation after we've converted it, but if you're careful and you look, you can see it before. You don't have to go all the way to converting it. You just have to say what goes with what.
That's a lot of work.
That's why I was trying to show you the shortcut. Y minus 4 is the fourth equation, equals negative 2 times x plus 2. What's going to happen when I distribute this? It's not going to be 3 over 4, but it is going to be negative 2x. That means that this goes with this equation. Those two would be parallel. Now, you can play with them on paper like this, or you can graph them. Just be careful graphing, because we're not perfectionists, and sometimes our lines don't look as parallel as maybe they're supposed to. Right? Okay, number 5. Same direction, except it's asking if it's perpendicular. What are the equations? We have y is equal to 2/3 x minus 4.
You forgot the x.
Oh, I did. Thank you. Y is equal to negative 3/2 x plus 2. Right there, I'm going, oop, that's positive, that's negative. They are reciprocals. I think they're going to go together. What are the other equations? Y equals negative 1, x equals 3. These two would be perpendicular. Because they're going to be undefined, and zero. These two would be perpendicular because they have these opposite slopes, the negative reciprocal. How can I prove it? 2/3 times a negative 3/2 gives me negative 6/6, which is equal to negative 1. This right here is the special case.
That's me.
Especially in your pajamas.
It's an owl, by the way.
It's very cute. Harpreet, you missed out on pajama day. Best school day of the year. Number 6. Actually, I'm not going to do number 6. Okay, the last day of school is an awesome day, too. But then I miss you guys. Okay, number 22. We're going to do it 2 different ways. If you are in the book, turn the page because it's on the next page. You're being given 2 things. One is an equation, and the other is a point on the graph that's not in that equation. And you're being asked to find an equation that would include that point that's parallel. So, I'm visual. I want to graph it first. These will be around if you are interested later. Just make a real quick sketchy one, though. We are given y equals 3x minus 7.
Can I get a chicken fry?
Can I keep focus, please? Huey? How do I graph this line? Start at negative 7. I'm going to graph my slope as 3/1. I love how everybody calls us in the middle of class like we're not like teaching and stuff. Actually, he's probably returning my question earlier, so I appreciate him. Okay, this is my parallel, or the line that I want the other one to be parallel to.
We can't see it.
Okay. Here's my graph of this equation.
That's a really nice graph.
The book gave us also 0.04, which is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. It starts up here. Clearly, that point is not on this line. We need to make another line that's parallel to this. But really, what the book has asked you for is the equation that goes with it. Okay, so yes, I can make the graph. I've got 0.04. If it's parallel, it's still going to have 3/1 as its slope, right? So I can go up 3 and over 1. And I can graph my line.
Is it parallel?
That's not answering the question, though. The question asks, what's the equation? Well, the equation for the second one is going to be y is equal to 3x plus 4. Which is great because this one was on the y-axis. If you have your book open, look at number 23. It gives an equation and a point on another line, and you have to come up with the other equation. It's not as easy. So I'm going to do one more with you guys as number 23. I'm going to show you this one in 2 ways. One way we're going to use the graph to find the line and then the equation. And the other way we're going to use the equation and the point to find it. So for 23, the first equation we're given is y is equal to 1/2 x plus 5. We're starting at 5, and it's positive 1/2, so it's going to be a positive line. I'm going to go up 1 and over 2. And I can graph it. Again, you guys know, I've told you many times, I'm a really visual learner, so for me, I like to try to graph it first. It's not always the most efficient way. The other thing in the book is they gave us 4, -3. So I can go to 4 and down to -3. And I can use 1/2 and I can make a line. Am I going to be positive I'm getting the right y-intercept though with my graph here? Because I'm not really positive how accurate my graphing is. I mean, that kind of looks parallel, but it also looks like these two are coming closer together, mm-hmm. right? So right now it looks like this is the y-intercept, but I'm not convinced I graphed it correctly. Do you guys see what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I know that the second equation is going to be y is equal to 1/2 x something. It looks like that something is negative, but I want to be positive I know what my b is.
Yeah.
And I can use this and this equation to find it. If I'm doing y equals mx plus b, and I don't know the b, but I have the m, and I have an x and a y, then I can graph and solve for b. Do you see what I did there? I took the numbers we were given in this xy pair. This is the x. That's where x is in the equation. This is the y. That's where the y is in the equation. What do I don't know the b, so I'm going to go find it. What is 1/2 of 4?
2.
2 plus b equals -3. I'm trying to get b by itself, so I'm going to subtract the
2.
2. 3 and 2, both negative, are going to give me -5 equals b. Now I can go up here and say, okay, we were right, it was a negative. And I can check my graph. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I did hit it. I'm not convinced I would be that accurate the next time. I still think my line looks crooked.
Mine did too.
Okay. There are also problems in the book that are asking you to do this with reciprocals, but we're not going to practice that today. I want you to do a few problems where you're doing what we did over here. You're going to take equations and you're going to identify from the slope, are they parallel? Then you're going to have some equations where it's, are they perpendicular? And then you're going to have 6 problems where you're given an equation and a point and you have to find the other equation. Okay? Here's the work. You have 11 minutes. I want to be able to check this work tomorrow. So do your best to try to get them done as much as you can in class. I would love it if you could get to this part before you leave. Not finish it necessarily, but get there, because that's where you're going to have the questions. Okay? There is graph paper up here on my desk. I have a stamp, the other two are on the round table. Let's get to work and use our time well.